Hello, my name is Rashmi from the Department of Criminology, Raksha Shakti University, Ahmedabad, Gujarat. Today, the title of the module is Understanding the Internet. The objectives of the module are, number one, to understand how the domain name system works. Number two, to explore website creation and database-driven websites. Number three, to gain an overview of the World Wide Web. This module assumes that students are familiar with the knowledge of basic understanding of the computer networks, internet, IP addresses, servers, and web distribution. In the present age of information technology, use of internet is becoming quite popular for accessing information on any topic of your interest. It also provides tremendous opportunities to students, researchers, and professionals for getting information on matters related to academic and professional topics and lot more. In the present world, most of the people who have computers around themselves use the internet to access information from the World Wide Web, exchange messages and documents and e-services. The internet supplements the traditional tools you use to gather information. Data graphics, news and correspond with other people. Used skillfully, the internet shrinks the world and brings information, expertise and knowledge on nearly every subject imaginable straight to your computer. The internet impacts us as human-computer interaction professionals in two major ways, as users and consumers of the information provided on the internet and as designer of information sources and network-based computing system. This module will also focus on the World Wide Web, domain name system and website creation, as well as how an email works. The World Wide Web, also referred to as WWW, is the fastest growing area of the internet. The WWW is a body of virtual information stored on web servers. A web server is a computer system that runs a software to allow people to look at the web pages stored on it from their own PCs. Web design is a multifaceted term for a variety of skills used to produce anything from an accessible document to a multimedia experience. The web has the following functions. It acts as a means for publishing online information. The web enables you to lay out text and graphics of the pages on the screen and to insert titles, photos, captions, and so on. It is also a means for retrieving online information via hypertext links at the click of a button. You can also use web search programs to find the information you want. A web page may also contain forms for conducting commercial transactions across the internet and include other applications. For example, spreadsheets, video clips, sound clips, and so on. The web is therefore simultaneously a means of online publishing, a way of accessing, storing, and retrieving information, as well as a means of sending, acquiring, and querying data across the internet. Most importantly, the web allows the use of hypertext links that can take you to any computer on the internet. All these functions work by using the hardware, the wires, the cables, and the computers, the satellite links that are used to send information from computer to computer using internet protocols. The web also acts as an interface for looking at information retrieved. This is done by virtue of a web browser. The basic components of the web are web servers, servers, web clients, HTTP protocol, and a browser. A key point that helped make the web successful is that it is multi-platform. What this means is that it does not matter what kind of computer you are using. You can still view information published on other usually incompatible machines. The three fundamental technologies that remained the foundation of today's web are HTML, which is hypertext markup language. It is also the markup formatting language for the web. URI, Uniform Resource Identifier, which is a kind of address that is unique and used to identify to each resource on the web. It also commonly known as URI. HTTP, Hypertext Transfer Protocol, which allows for the retrieval of linked resources from across the web. This module will also provide basic understanding of the domain name system. An effective domain name system, that is DNS, is critical to internet access speeds. The bandwidth of your internet connection is irrelevant if the DNS system is slow. DNS is essentially the telephone directory of the internet. Just as a phone number such as 604-525-5555 is mapped to a name like John Smith, every device that communicates over the internet has a unique machine-readable IP address that is mapped to a human-readable domain name such as www.incognito.com. If we need to contact the device, we can use its domain name. DNS supports high performance, availability and scalability through the use of data hierarchies, data replication and caching. The three main components of the DNS system are domain name space, name server and domain name resolution. A brief overview about email will also be provided here. Email or electronic mail is a paperless method of sending messages, letters, video and graphics from one person to another or many people at the same time via internet. Email is very fast, easy and much cheaper than using the post office. It only takes few seconds to arrive at the destination. It works 24 hours a day and 7 days a week. You will also be acquainted with website creation in this module. A website is usually a set of web files hosted by a computer running a web server. Design and implementation of a website has several aspects such as the content embedded in the site, the page sent from the site, and the functionality of the site. The topics of a website are varying and depend on the owner's interest and mission. We will learn about database-driven websites. They are a type of dynamic websites. Important characteristics of the dynamic website are the ability to authenticate you, that is, to verify your identity, record your performance, history, keep track of your interactions, and when you start a session and until you leave, and sometimes even from session to session. Businesses establish websites for many different reasons. Although some only require simple brochure-style websites to communicate basic corporate and product information, others have more sophisticated requirements. Many companies have a need to publish large volumes of data to the web, data that is constantly changing. Other firms want to deploy e-business and e-commerce applications that enable visitors to initiate self-service transactions 24 hours each day over the internet in a secured environment. As websites become increasingly sophisticated, the need to better manage website content increases. There is a widespread need to manage website content in a robust relational databases where the data can be accessed and used to dynamically generate web pages. There are a number of client-side scripting languages, example JavaScript, that are used to dynamically alter web page content. The changed content can originate from the same website or from another website. We would need a database-driven website if our information changes very often, just like in a banking site. Most organizations have a great deal of information in databases and could benefit if this information is made available online. When the content on a site reaches a critical mass, it's time to stop managing it as resources embedded in a static HTML and start to create a database-driven website. After completing this module, you'll be able to understand how the domain name system works, to explore the concept of email, to get an overview of the World Wide Web, and to understand the concepts of website creation and database-driven websites. The internet is a multifaceted and diversified network. The whole essence of the internet system is varied and large. The use of internet has also grown increasingly diversified over the past years. Today, the internet is much more complex because of the technological advancement. The internet landscape has also changed with the development of the chat programs, personal profiles, or web page. Understanding the internet as a medium, both as a media and communication system, will help us gain a better insight into the complex and widespread culture of the whole online environment. The working principle of the domain name system. The domain name system are alphanumeric names for IP addresses, for example, neon.cs.virginia.edu. Since IP addresses are hard to remember, hence domain names are used. The domain name system, DNS, is an internet-based database that translates between domain names and IP addresses. They are formed from several or at least two labels, that is parts, that are separated by dots. Labels in the name are numbered from right to left. The top label domain will be in the most extreme right mark in the domain name, and the subdomains will be located on the left. The domain name system is divided into 127 levels, and each level contains a maximum of 63 characters. However, the maximum number of characters a domain name can have is 254 characters. All DNS servers are located in a hierarchical order. Each domain or subdomain supports multiple authorized servers which contain all the necessary information about the domain. The procedure of DNS is as follows. The information of the computer is saved in the domain name servers. The servers are widely distributed over the internet. In order to connect with a host on the internet, the domain name should be entered in the URL of the browser. The computer will then connect to the default name servers and ask for the IP addresses of the host. The name server will then let the computer know about the IP addresses of the query host. Once the computer gets the IP address of the host, the computer communicates with the host. The design principle of DNS is as follows. The naming system is hierarchical and logical based, which is called the domain namespace. The hierarchy can be represented by a tree. They are administered by an Internet Central Name Registration Authority. The administration of namespace is delegated to organizations. The hierarchical namespace is done by a hierarchy of name servers. Each server is responsible for a contiguous portion of the DNS namespace called zone. Names of host can be assigned without location of the IP network. The allocation of domain name follows the allocation of IP addresses. As for example, the domain name www.example.com had network prefix 198.105.232.4. The mode in the DNS tree represents a DNS name. Every node in a DNS domain tree can be identified by a fully qualified domain name. The FQDN consists of labels such as EDU and period such as dot, characters and numerals. FQDNs are not case sensitive. The three types of top level domain are organizational, which consists of three character codes, as for example, GOV, EDU, ORG. The second type is geographical, which consists of two character country or region code, such as US, VAIN. The third type is called the reverse domain, which is a special domain used for IP addresses to name mapping. The top level organizational domains are COM for commercial organizations, EDU for educational institutions, GOV for governmental institutions, INT for international organizations, NET for networking organizations, ORG for non-profit organizations. The DNS resolver looks up the information associated with the nodes. Resolving usually requires several name servers to find the needed information. They communicate with name servers by sending DNS queries and heeding DNS responses. The DNS servers can not only encode the character names in the IP addresses, but can also reconstruct the IP addresses in the name of the characters. The domain name looks into two types of queries. Recursive query, which is when the name server of a host cannot resolve a query. The server issues a query to resolve the query. The second type of query is known as iterative query, which is when the name server of a host cannot resolve a query and it sends a referral to another server to the resolver. Email is a tool which is used by nearly every person who has an internet connection. Email stands for electronic mail, which is equivalent to being a modernized version of sending a letter to the other side of the world within minutes. Documents and photos can be attached to the email as well. Every person has a unique email address. Email was developed in the late 1980s and early 1970s by the Advanced Research Projects Agency network known as ARPANET that was built as part of research project by the US Department of Defense. An email address always has an ed, which is pronounced as ed. An example of email address is nancy@gmail.com. Here Nancy is the username which refers to a unique name of the user. Gmail.com is the domain name of the company or organization that provides the email service. The receiver gets an email in the mailbox and can read and answer if required. The message exits in the mailbox until the receiver deletes or reads it. The advantages of an email are: email is a low-cost person-to-person communication system. Email is fast as the message, which is delivered within minutes. Only the receiver can open the message, hence privacy is maintained. Email is easy to operate. The storage of the email is safe and unlimited, which can be associated anytime and from anywhere. The World Wide Web. In order to establish a fast and rapid connection over the internet, the World Wide Web as a network was established. The idea of World Wide Web was developed by Tim Berners-Lee and Robert Calillo in November 1990. The concept of World Wide Web is based upon two key concepts: hypertext documents, which provides links to other documents with similar words or phrases; network-based information retrieval, where the document is stored as a file which can also be generated on request. The web contains millions of documents such as personal notes, reports, figures, blueprints, drawings, and so on. The web has evolved considerably over the last 10 years as a distributed system that produces vast amounts of information. In addition, it can also accept requests for storing new documents. The Uniform Resource Locator (URL) is a contact address that specifies where a document is located. The overall organization of the web starts with getting a request for a document, then the server fetches document from a local file, and lastly, the browser in the client machine properly displays the document. Most documents contain references to other documents, and such references are called hyperlinks. The hyperlinks are displayed in the browser and the user can select a link by clicking on it. The web documents are expressed in a special language known as hypertext markup language, or simply HTML. The HTML document contains keywords, headers, lists, and tables. The most powerful feature of HTML is the ability to express parts of a document in the form of a script. Some of the essential components of WWW are: the information is delivered using hypertext and hypermedia documents or objectives. The communication in the web is based on the hypertext transfer protocol between the user and the servers. The HTTP does not need an open communication and does not require a server to maintain information on its client. The web has an integration of documents over the internet. The HTML document offers links to other HTTP servers. There are two kinds of processes that the web works upon. Browsers, which gives us the user access to all web documents, and the other is servers, which handles incoming HTTP requests by fetching the requested document and returning it to the client. The functions of the web are as follows. The World Wide Web works by establishing hypertext, hypermedia links between documents anywhere on the network. The web browsers are capable of interacting with different kinds of servers. The web has a common address scheme, which makes it possible to identify what the user wants. The web browsers are extensive and can handle a wide variety of resources. Website creation consists of a collection of HTML document files. Websites can be created as a simple informational website or two-way sites that allow visitors to interact. Websites are read with a program called the web browser, as for example, Internet Explorer, Firefox, Safari, or Google Chrome. The only type of documents that these web browsers can display is HTML files. The web browser makes sure that other people's computers can connect to the document and request a copy of the page and display it. The web server program helps save the web page when connected over the internet. Creating a website involves the following steps. Firstly, registering a domain name is the first step towards creating a website. For example, domain names can be www.febnews.com. The second step is to create a few pages using HTML and subsequently use database techniques such as PHP. PHP stands for Hypertext Processor, which is the mostly widely used server-side language in the web world. The PHP program is a Word file. These files tend to end with .php. In order to store the content of the website to a web server, a program called the HTML editor, which saves the finished document in a HTML format. In order to upload the content of the HTML files across the internet to the web server, the method of FTP, that is file transfer protocol, is used. Three important things to consider before creating a website are: what type of site one is creating, as for example, if it is an informational site or an entertainment site, why the site is created, and who the site is for. The target audience should be clear in mind before a website creation. These three things matter because the layout of the page depends on those. The menu on the website should be clear and concise so that the visitors do not have difficulty finding any information. The choices in a menu should also be obvious and mutually exclusive. The website should also be easily accessible. Database-driven websites are common types of dynamic web pages. Dynamic web pages change every time they are loaded. Database-driven websites are also known as web applications. They are distributed applications where one part of the application is carried out on a web server and the other runs on the client computer with a web browser. These websites use database to store and collect information. The information is stored in a table format, which is showed on the site as HTML files. These websites are user-friendly, which let you to add, edit, or delete any information or create new ones. Examples of database-driven websites are e-commerce sites because these sites need to keep the prices and offers of their services up to date. Another example includes blogs and online community forums, which needs regular updates by users. Some of the advantages of database-driven websites are as follows. It is suitable for e-commerce sites and online retailers where information needs to be updated frequently. It is easier and faster to update information and content through these websites. Changing the content does not need specialized expertise or knowledge in HTML programming. It has reduced error rate as data entry employees might make mistakes, and rectifying such issues on database-driven websites are easier and more efficient. Changing layout, trends, and patterns is also extensive and can be done anytime on these websites. Understanding the internet is crucial in order to gain a better insight into the global network of computers. The internet has come a long way since its inception in the 1970s and still has a long way to go. DNS, which stands for Domain Name System, controls the domain name's website and email settings as well. It sets a protocol for how computers exchange data on the internet and on private networks. Later in the 1990s, the birth of the web took place, which has been evolving till date. It is by far the most used application in the world. With the web came in the development of website creation and database-driven sites, which helps a user to open up a personalized website. The widespread network of the internet has had a tremendous impact on the lives of millions of people and the way they study, communicate and make businesses with each other. Thank you for watching. I hope this module has been helpful.